Hello everyone, in this tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to make an expression injector for After Effects. Now this is a very simple script that just allows you to select the position, scale, or opacity of a layer, and then manually input your text like a wiggle expression, and then I can say apply that to this footage here, and then simply apply the expression and see the changes. So the code for this is pretty simple. It's only about 50 lines long, so let's go ahead and get started. Create a new JavaScript file and zoom in here. We'll start off with the UI and we'll create a main window, which we'll set to be a new window. Just want it to be a palette and we'll call this expression injector and we'll set the size to undefined. And then we'll want to set the orientation of our main window to be a column, so all the groups inside of it go from top to bottom. And then we'll start off by making our first group, which will be our selector for the property. We'll just say group one, reference the main window, and add a group, undefined size, and we'll just call it group one. And I'm going to set the alignment of this group to be left, so it's on the left side of our UI. And we're going to create a dropdown called property dropdown, and we'll add this to group one. And we'll add a drop-down list, the undefined size, and for this we're going to put in an array of string values we want. So we'll say position, scale, and opacity, and these will be the three options we can choose from. Then we'll make a second group for the text we can put into it. We'll just add this to the main window. Undefined size and call it group 2. I'm also going to set the alignment of this group to left as well, and we'll add our expression text and we'll add this to group 2, and we're going to add an edit text undefined size, and we'll just say insert your expression here. And then finally we'll add a third group for our button to execute everything. Add it to the main window, undefined size, and group 3. And for group 3, I'm going to align this to the right side just to see what that will look like. And in this group, we're just going to make an inject button, and we'll add that to group 3. And it's going to be a button, undefined size, and the text will say inject. Now we'll go ahead and grab our window, center it, and we'll show it. Now if we preview how this looks, we need to set the default selection for our dropdown to be one of these values, and the size for this is actually good. So to change the selection here, I'll just grab the property dropdown, and I'll set the selection, and we'll set that to 0, and it will select the first value, which is position. So now if we run it again, the UI is how we want it, so let's go ahead and implement the code for how this will work. So the first thing we'll do is grab our inject button, and we'll add an onClick function, so every time it clicks, it's going to do something. So set that equal to a function, and for this function, we'll just call it inject expression. And the way we want this to work is just to work with one layer we have selected. So before we go into the inject expression function, which we should make right here, we'll want to check how many layers are selected. Say if app.project.activeItem is equal to null, so no comps are selected, we'll say alert please select a comp and a layer, and we'll return false so it exits this function and just goes back to the UI. So that's the first check. We'll create a variable called comp, which we'll set to app.project.activeItem. So if we select this comp, this is going to be our comp variable. And then we'll have one more check, and we'll say if comp.selectedLayers.length is not equal to 1. So if they don't have one layer selected, we'll say please only select one layer. And again, return false to exit this function. And now inside of our inject expression call here, we're going to send through comp.selectedLayersIndex0, because if they have only one selected layer, it's going to be in the first index. And over here, we'll pass the argument through by calling this our layer. And now we can do some stuff with the inject expression function. The first thing we'll do is grab our layer, and we'll grab a property. But because this property is in a dropdown, we're going to need to make a separate function. So we'll make a function called getProperty. And in this function, we'll create a switch statement. And we're going to be analyzing the dropdown list here. So we're going to switch the property dropdown and the selection index. So if it's set to 0, it'll be position, 1 is scale, and 2 is opacity. So our first case is 0. And with that, we're going to return position. And of course, add your break. Case 1, return scale. Add a break. And the third case, case 2, will return opacity. So inside of our inject function, if we go to layer.property, we're just going to run getProperty. And that's going to return either position, scale, or opacity based on what we've selected over here. And to inject the expression, we're just going to say the expression for this property. And we're going to set that equal to our edit text, which is called expression text. And we don't want to just reference the object of the edit text. We want to actually grab the text inside of it. So we'll say .text. Now let's go ahead and run it and see how it works. First off, let's try and select more than one layer. It says, please only select one layer. If we select no layers, please select only one layer. So I'll select this middle layer where the explosion happens. And on the position, I'll insert a keyframe. We'll just say wiggle 10 times a second, 15, and we'll inject that. And as you can see, we got no notification that it worked. But if we hit UU on our layer, you can see it's added this wiggle expression to the position. And now we've added some more camera blur to this shot. Of course, we'll need to scale it up a little bit to compensate, but it's looking a lot better. Of course, this doesn't always work. For example, if I were to try and wiggle the scale, it's going to ununiformly transform the scale over time here. So I'm sure you could add some if statements or checks to see if it's a valid expression. If it returns an error in After Effects, you could just say, please enter a valid expression. But that's a subject for another tutorial. Alright guys, that's it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. New After Effects tutorials every Monday. Make sure you hit the like button if you enjoyed it. Ask any questions in the comments or recommendations for future videos. And we'll see you next time.